everyone. Say hi. Today I'll be sharing how I like to make baby food for this little girl. This is going to be a steaming method of a little bit of water and just apples. There's other options I will show you of what baby foods she likes as first starter foods. One of her favorites is definitely banana and avocado. But yeah, I'm gonna do apple right now. Super easy to have, no chemicals. It's not bottled, it's not from the store. You know exactly what's in it. So this girl's almost 6 months old. I started giving her solids a few weeks ago, and she's loving them. Baby food can definitely add up, and you don't always have time to go to the store to buy it. So this kind of baby food that I make, I like to bottle it up, and I even freeze it so that when I do need it, I just pull it out of the freezer, I let it thaw. But yeah, it's really good. I think it tastes so much better than store-bought. Like if you buy applesauce or even like the sweet potato, the canned sweet potato versus the one you make at home, it's such a difference. Like I can't even explain like the taste quality when you make it at home. It's so good. Like, yeah, Bella?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay guys, so to start the applesauce, I will start by peeling apples. I've got three here. I want to keep it fresh, so I'm just gonna do a small portion. So okay, and you can use whatever apples you like, but I'm just using Gala because I like how they are sweet. Okay, once you got your apples peeled, then you are gonna need to cut them up. So I'm cutting these where I just cut out the core, and then I put that aside, and then I'm gonna cook everything else. Okay, so once you have them cut up, mine are about an inch thick, I'm gonna throw them into this kind of pan because I will be steaming them. I know some people, if they don't have this kind of pan, you can see on the bottom it has holes. If they don't have that, they could just do a regular pan with a little bit of water, but I like to do mine like this. Okay, so my pan is on, and I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna boil this water first before I add any fruit to it. All right, so we got the water boiling, so I'm gonna go ahead and throw in the apples. And I'm gonna cover it. All right, so you can still hear the water boiling in there. See how I'm poking this, and it's still kind of hard to go through. So I'm gonna give it another like 2 minutes. It's been about 4 or 5 minutes, and my fork needs some effort to go through. So I'm gonna let it cook for another couple minutes, just because we wanna make sure that when we mash it up, there will be no chunks and everything's gonna be nice and smooth. Okay, so it's been another 3 minutes, and when I poke it, it goes right through. So, it's done. I'm gonna turn that off. Pull that off the heat. So I got the apples in here, and I'm gonna give them a few minutes to cool down. Do not throw away this water because we will be adding it to the apples to make it more runny. And it does have like the drippings from the apple, and it's got that flavor, so do not toss it. All right, so before I put my apples into the Nutribullet, I'm gonna add, let's see, it's probably about 2 tablespoons of water, and then we're gonna put it onto the blender. So I could see it's a little thick, so I'm gonna add a little bit more water to it. See, it needs to be a lot more runny than that. Alright, so I added a little bit more water, and you can see how it's a little more runny. So basically the texture of applesauce, you know, you don't want it too thick, you don't want it to be too watery either. So I'm just going to let this cool down completely before I give it to Isabella, but yeah, that's about the texture you want. Alright, so I got the applesauce nice and cool. Bella, you want some? Is that too sour for you? She hasn't tried applesauce before. Hey! Do you want more? Alright guys, so the applesauce is done. It was actually really good. I think I'm gonna make more for my toddlers. I have a 2-year-old and a 4-year-old, and they love applesauce in the pouch. So I think this is gonna be a perfect snack for them. I could just put into a cup. So those baby food jars that you buy, you can definitely keep them. That's what I did. I would wash them, and when this applesauce is done or whatever baby food I make, I would put it into those little jars and either put them in the fridge or the freezer. So if you have those, you could use that. If not, I'm just gonna use whatever little glass jars or cups that I have on hand right now. Yeah, if you guys like this video, if you guys want to have more advice or other different recipes, let me know in the comments. This is my third time around as a mom, so I've done a lot and I've made plenty of other foods. So I'll probably be making sweet potatoes or pear or I don't know, any other kind of food options. And I'll be making more videos on that, so stay tuned. Bella, say bye. Bella.